Hello everyone, in this tutorial we are going to create a liquid gradient background in Inkscape. Let's begin. Create a new background with the rectangle tool, click this icon. And make sure you turn on the snap to the pick border to make it auto fit when you dragging. And change it to the gradient color, click this gradient tool. Or the shortcut is G. And just drag like this. This linear gradient, you can double click and press D to activate the dropper tool and change the color to this color, or you can input this color code to here. For the bottom, just double click and click this color. Okay, we can adjust it. Next, we're going to create the semi-3D lines with the scatter effect, but first create a circle with the circle tool, click this icon. Hold Ctrl Shift while scaling to make it proportional scale like this. Give some gradient color, you can click this gradient tool. Press G and just drag in. And double click on this point. Press D to activate the dropper tool. Change the color to this color. For the bottom, just double click. Change the color to this color. Okay, you can still adjust it. And with move tool, I just scale it a little, press Ctrl Shift. Draw lines with the Bezier tool, press B. And let's start from here to here. And right click to release. Now we're going to create these smart 3D lines, but first make sure the circle is in the top, otherwise it's not working. Click this icon to raise selection. Convert it to path, and path, choose object to path. Then select these two objects, hold shift then click, and these two, just while holding shift, just click it. Then go to extension, generate from path, choose the scatter. Make sure you turn on this option. This is in clone because you want to clone this circle along with these lines, and this just randomly. Active this lab preview, and try to reduce the space, make it minus. Because we want to make it close. Sometimes you will get an error message like this. You see the limit here is 30.9. So let's change the number below this. Just hit OK. And try again. Choose extension, generate from path, choose the scatter. And let's reduce it. I believe around this it's OK. Let's see. Then click apply, then close. Create a clipping mask, press Ctrl D on the background. Hold shift, then click on this line. And right click, choose the set clip. Just delete these previous lines. Adjust the gradient, click this circle. And press F2 or the edit mode. Okay, let's see. We can also increase the size by scaling it. So these lines will scale it too. Add more lines with the Bezier tool, press B. And let's start from here to here. And right click to release. Before we do the scatter extension, make sure the circle on the top. Okay, you see it's on below the line. Just raise up. Click this and shift click. Go to extension. Generate from path, choose the scatter. Try to activate this live review. Let's reduce the number till it's smooth or until you get the message. Make a clipping mask, duplicate the background, shift then click, and right click, choose set clip. Just delete this line. And send it to the lower back. You can click this icon. Okay, I'm just going to add more in here with Bezier tool. Before we do the sketcher extension, make sure the circle on the top, okay, as you see, just raise up. If we did the extension before, we can make it fast by selecting this two and go to extension, choose the previous extension. Right, so I'm just going to duplicate this, press Ctrl D, and click this, right click, set clip. Next, create a text with text tool, press T, and type, change the font to, change it to, you can reduce the spacing by selecting all, and click this, change the color to white. Next, draw a rectangle, press Ctrl Shift, like this, and change it only stroke, click this to white and remove the fill, change the stroke tile to 20, and you can adjust it, and send it to the lower back. Add more elements, I'm just going to add some circle, draw some tiny circle, and change it to fill only. Press Ctrl D to duplicate, and hold Ctrl Shift to make it straight when you move it. Convert to path by selecting all, and go to path, choose the object to path. Add some interpolate extension by selecting these two, and go to extension, generate from path, choose the interpolate. And you can turn up this left preview to see. Click apply, then close. So I'm just going to duplicate this and place where you want. And we can rotate it by clicking again till you see this rotate. Then hold Ctrl Shift while rotating, like this. Place it on here. Just add more. Alright, just feel free to add more elements. Hope you learned something new, how to create this My 3D Lines effect in Inkscape. When creating this effect, it requires more resources, so you must take care on that. I'm Zakay from Zakay Design, create something good today. Thanks for watching.